everybody. So I'm getting ready to put up another eastern bluebird house. So here in Connecticut, we get the eastern bluebird. We have one house down there that already has 4 eggs in it.
It's got 4 nice light blue eggs in there.
Then we have barn swallows in this one, and then we have wrens in the other one. And then later, we're going to be going down to the basement and going to make a bluebird house for you guys. Show you how easy it is. You can do it 30 minutes. You can do it all hand tools. You can do power tools, however you want to do it. It's a lot of fun. It's really fun when the bluebirds actually go into the house as opposed to the wrens or the sparrows, which are always trying to get the bluebirds. So there's a little problem going on there with the birds. So if you have enough houses up there, eventually one of them is going to be occupied by the bluebirds. That easy. So now hopefully when I leave here today, some of the bluebirds just scouted out and they'll decide that they want to have their young in here.
So the one that I use, it has side opening, so you can go ahead and you can check out the birds and then you can clean them out. But don't clean them out after the first one, because a lot of times they'll have another brood.
So just like this says, where have all the bluebirds gone? Well, I don't know, but we have quite a few of them here. So I sent away for plans for our bluebird house from the North American Bluebird Society, and it seems to be working very well for the birds in our area. I'm in Connecticut. Unfortunately, you also do get wren and you also get the sparrow in there. And a lot of times they like to go in there and wreak havoc with the bluebirds. So if you end up getting a bluebird all the way from egg to maturity to flying to going away to empty nest, then you've done your part. Good luck with all your bluebird activity. I think bluebirds are fantastic. If you end up having a couple in there, that means you've added more to their population. They're a very hard bird to keep going, and I really don't understand why. Seems like the other birds out there don't like to have the bluebirds around. They try to do whatever they can to kick them out of the nest. So I'm going to give you the specifications. According to the Bluebird Society, we're going to go ahead and make ourselves a bluebird box, and we'll go from there.
Okay, so these plans are built on the assumption that you're using 3/4-inch stock. Sometimes the stock I use is from barn board, which is sometimes 7/8 or 1 inch. So I just have to offset the numbers to accommodate that. We'll go over the numbers on what the 3/4-inch is, and then we're going to be going over there how I have to do it for mine, because right now I'm going to be making mine out of barn boards.
So I'm going to be using the barn boards that you see here, because this is something that I had on hand. So I'm going to have to offset my numbers a little bit, because this is 7/8 inch thickness. So I'll get into that when I'm making the birdhouse. Now for this project, you definitely do not need power tools. I just happen to have a bunch of them because I used to do woodworking years ago, where I actually sold bluebird houses, bird feeders and trellises and stuff like that right outside of my front yard. So I have the tools at my disposal, so I'm going to utilize them. So the first cut I'm going to make is going to be the back and the front. So the back is the one that you attach to either a cedar pole or a metal pole or whatever you're going to do with it. So based on a 3/4 inch thickness of a board, you would do that at 5.5 inches. Now, since I'm using 7/8 inch barn board, I have to do it at 5 3/4 inch. So the back piece is going to be 15.5 inches long. Now, since I want to have a nice clean edge on to start with, what I'm going to do is just going to put my board on the rip fence, line it up to where I can skim off maybe an eighth or so, eighth of an inch, just to make a nice clean edge. Now I'm going to set it to 5 3/4. Okay, so that's right on these mats. I'm just going to cut this one down to 15.5. Well, you know, you can actually keep it at whatever length you need. Right now it's at 20. That's kind of long. I'm just going to cut up because here it looks like there's some softness to the wood, so there's no reason for that right there. So I can just kind of get rid of that. So I'll end up cutting the back piece to 16. So the front piece is going to be based on what the sides are. So the sides are going to be 10 3/4 inch at the highest point down to 9 3/4 inch, and it's going to be 4 inches wide. So that's about a 15 degree angle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rip a couple pieces of 4 inches stock. I'll cut a little heavy, I'll cut it at 11, and then I'll fine tune it down from 3/4, and then I'll end up taking a 15 degree cut, and that'll be giving me my sides, and then we can base the front off of that. All right, so I'm gonna cut my stock. It's longer than 11, but that's okay, I just have some throwaway. So I wanna get a nice clean edge. So I'm just gonna take about an eighth off or quarter. Get a nice clean edge. I'm going to set my fence to 4. So I also know the inside diameter of the box is going to be 4x4 for the bottom piece. So I can also utilize one of these to just place it on here and cut it down to a 4-inch piece. When I first started making birdhouses, I was measuring everything. But what you do, all you need to do is just eyeball it for 45 degrees off of the corners, just enough to allow water to escape if it ends up getting inside the house. All right. This is the bottom piece for the birdhouse. So now we're going to go over here and we're going to be ending up cutting up the sides, and then we'll cut up the front. And then we'll be making the hole, which is 1.5 inches. Apparently the bluebirds like 1.5 inches. It seems to work for the ones here. And then we'll put a roof on there, put it together, and then we'll have a birdhouse.
Okay, so since we have two pieces, we can end up utilizing, I just have a simple jig here. So we know that the length is going to be 10 3/4. So we'll mark out 10 3/4. And then we're going to take off 15 degree angle. And for the other side, well, I want to get a clean cut first. But when you cut it on the chop saw at 15 degrees, you have to do it on the side is going to be to the bottom, facing away from you. So they're going to match. This way you have two matching sides. Ten and three quarters. Nine and three quarters. Perfect. Alright, so I have my sides, I have the bottom, and I have the back. So the next piece we need to make is the front. So the front, all you have to do is just kind of eyeball this. And just remember that you're going to have a roof on it too, if you're trying to make things so they're equal. So we know that the front is going to start here, but the front also has to have the same 15 degree angle that the side does. So I'm going to go ahead and go over to the chop saw, make a 15 degree angle, and then I'll end up making the final length of it based on this piece here. So this is without measuring, because measuring can sometimes mess you up. You end up being off a little bit. This way you can kind of make it to the piece of wood that you're working with. So this is going to be my front piece. I just need to set my saw at a 15 degree angle. And just make it anywhere. So I got my front piece. I'm just going to place it on top of the side. Line up the top, which is 15 degree bevel to the end, and just make a line. Now I'm going to go to the chop saw and go ahead and cut that. So we can just test the front to the side by placing it on, feeling the bottom, and it's the same. So we did it without actually measuring. Now we need to make a hole in the front piece. So you want to have the hole 1 1/8 from the top. So in order to do that, it's going to be 1.5 inches in diameter. So you need to split that in half.
So that is 3/4 of an inch. So 3/4 of an inch plus 1 1/8 is going to be 1 7/8 inches where you're going to be placing your drill bit. So I'm going to come down 1 7/8. And I need to center it. So since this is a 7/8 inch wide, so this is 5 3/4. 5 3/4 is going to be 2 7/8. 2 7/8 is going to be my centerpiece. Right here. If this was 3/4 inch stock, this would have been 5 1/2 inches wide. It would have been different for you to figure it out. So I'll just make a little center hole here and bring it on over to the drill press. So I've got it at the drill press. I'm going to line it up. I'm using a Forstner bit. You can use whatever 1 1/2 inch bit you have. So now that we have the hole cut, it's time to go ahead and put this thing together. So I always have my door swinging on the right side of the piece as I'm making it. I don't know why, it's just something that I've always done. So I'm going to place these two pieces on top of each other, the top and the front, and I'm just putting this in just to take up the space. Gonna just pre-drill. And then get a screw in here. Down here, pre-drill. So we're going to place the inside, the 4-inch piece. You want to have 1/4 to 1/2 inch so that way the rain drops off and doesn't wick back up into the nest. I'm going to pre-drill. And I eyeball it. God, when I started, I measured everything. It took me forever to make a house. Figure, it's made for birds. Birds don't care. Okay, so kind of eyeball it. And remember, we still have to make the roof. Thank you. So now the roof, we know that needs to have a 15 degree angle, the part that butts up against the back piece. Then you want to have an overhang of about half inch to an inch. They call for right around half inch. I go based on the board that I'm using. If I go a little heavy on it, it doesn't really matter. I don't think the birds are out there with a micrometer checking it out. So since we have 5 3/4, I'm just going to go through my stock and get a piece that's 6 3/4 or 7 or somewhere around there. Then we're going to make our cuts. So I've got a piece here that's 7 3/4. So it's going to be about an inch on each side. That's going to be fine for me. So we need to make it so the part butting to the back is going to be at a 15 degree angle. Set my chop saw for my 15. Supposed to be about 7 inches in length. I'm going to square it up. So we have the top made with the 15 degree bevel and 7 inches length. But before we put the top on, we want to get our second side on. So this is the side that we want to be able to open so we can check the eggs and to clean out the nest. And since the nests get hot inside, the boxes get hot inside, you want to go ahead and leave about a half inch of a gap where you're going to place your side. And since it has to pivot, what I like to do, I used to just put screws in, but I find that if you put a nail in, it seems to rotate a little easier and it doesn't get hung up from threads. So I'm just eyeballing it. It really doesn't have to be exact. So I use galvanized nails. But you also want to make sure that the holes are even so it opens up nice and square. So that this one in place. So after getting the nails in, you want to make sure that it does open freely so you can check the eggs, clean it out, and it closes. Okay, so it closes nicely. You want to go ahead and get our top on. We're just going to eyeball it. Pre-drill. that's it. One birdhouse. The only thing we need to do now is make it so we have a little latch here to keep it closed, so nothing can get in there. I just used a piece of hardwood, cut a hole in it, put a little screw in it, and we're going to go over to the little saw that I have over here and go ahead and make one of those. I just used a piece of hardwood. I have some old mahogany that I like to use. No certain size, I just like to make it a little thinner. So after I cut it to size, I like to just kind of break the edges a little bit. Just round it over. Somewhat smooth, it'll be fine. So I just need to put a hole in this for a pivot. Just kind of eyeball it. So I got a sacrificial piece of wood here. Don't want it too tight. So there it is. Check it out. All right. So the bluebird is a really nice bird to have in your backyard. You don't need to have all the power tools. You need a saw, hammer, whatever you have, just build it. You don't have to have a certain type of wood. I don't know about painting. I don't see why you need to paint it, because birds don't care about if it's painted. I like the barn boards because they look kind of natural, but then you can use pine, cedar, you can use anything. So just make yourself a house, see what comes to it, and then monitor it. Every year, the birds will come back. So good luck to whatever birds you end up having. Hopefully it's a bluebird. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.